All right, you guys, so basically I'm back. So I don't need a flash, but I have it on. We'll see about that later. I don't know. So basically I'm making a conscious decision, and I want to invite you guys to join me, and let's savor the smaller, more noticeable things in life, right? You know, like the kids, if you don't have any kids, the nice cup of tea in the morning, because that is going to get your life together, okay? The cup of tea is going to do it for you. And we want to rejuvenate our spirits. It's just something good that we should have on our mental, and we should definitely start incorporating this into our new routine, especially within the new year. I found that embracing these small joys, we not only reconnect with ourselves, but also create a foundation for mental health and our well-being overall. So let's take this journey, especially for this new year of 2024, and enjoy and get rid of these 10 things we do not need or we should bring into our new lives. Now, you deserve that peace. I deserve that peace. We deserve that contentment and those moments of joy to be a little elaborated coming into the new year. Let me go ahead, because I wrote notes, y'all, because you know your girl likes to talk. You know your girl likes to chit-chat and get straight to it. Well, no, I like to chit-chat and then we get straight to it, but you know how I am. Obviously, what was going on in 2023, especially the beginning of it, and how life was throwing some crazy curveballs at your girl. I was definitely working a lot. I was doing a lot of momming, and I was like overjudging myself quite a lot when I feel like I don't need to, and I didn't really need to. It was just me putting extra weight on myself, which I didn't need to, but I felt like I had to. And that's something that can distract and throw a lot of us off track. I just want to take 2024 to go towards the things that really do mean the most and will benefit us, at least on the inside, more than the, you know, what we've been putting pressure on ourselves for literally no reason, you know. So let's get into it. So this is the first time you see my beautiful face, you know, this cute little face. Please make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. I will have more of these chit-chats coming and these sit downs, so we can get into with each other and, you know, just check in every now and then with our mind spaces and, you know, just gather a little thought every now and then. So the first thing I put on the dumping in 2023 is going to be the unrealistic beauty standards. Now, everyone is very cliche when they say that, like, oh, you obviously can't have a BBL. No, I mean, like, I'm sick of going to the gym and there's a girl there that I'm like so fixated with. I'm like, you are so adorable. What do you, you know, what is your goal in the gym? My goal is just to be healthy. Okay. I know I have a thicker frame. That ain't going nowhere. You know, and it throws me off when I hear women in the gym talking about, oh, I'm trying to, you know, get a like a BBL booty or shrink their back. I mean, post-editing, I mean the frame, not the size. Like, I'm sorry, but stop listening to these men, okay? You can't get a BBL in the gym. That's, you can perk your butt up, but you're not getting a BBL. Like, there's no, listen. You can perk that toot up, but you're not getting a BBL from the gym. And I'm not going to lie to you, okay? You cannot get things that are genetically for people in the gym. And I hate that people are falling for that illusion. I know social media has a grip on some people's brains. You can't get rid of your hip dip. I mean, you could firm them, right? If you have hip dips, you can firm them. But you're not going to, like, get rid of them. They're not going to disappear. In the gym, you can't shrink your genetic wide back in the gym, and if anything, that makes it even wider. Like, it's not gonna shrink. But I feel like we need to start loving ourselves the way we are. Like, obviously there's some things you can fix and want to fix. Like, girl, I want a breast reduction bad. Like, I'm fiending for a breast reduction. But listen, I'm not gonna go to the gym and try to shrink my boobs, because it's not how that works. And I know genetically, my whole family has big breasts. So even if I was to shrink them per se, they wouldn't get to where my brain wants them to go. That's the whole body dysmorphia thing. And I really feel like we should leave that whole thing leave it in the old year. Okay, let's leave it in 2023. Okay, we can't get rid of things that are genetically here for us. We just have to learn to accept our bodies. And if we do want something cosmetically done, girl, go do it. Do what you want to do. Just don't get people like, if that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do. Don't let anyone shame you into doing something that you want to do. Who are you, ma'am? I'm sorry. You know, if you want your boobs done, go get your boobs done. But you don't gotta lie and say you go try to grow your boobies in the gym. That's just, that's, girl, let's leave that there. Okay, we'll circle back and we'll leave that there. We are in the year of actually loving who you are. And if you want to get something done cosmetic, then that's you and you want to get it done. Who, girl, we are not God. And even if we are God, we are not the divine feminine. So ain't nobody gonna tell you not to do what you want to do with your body. As long as you feel like it's worth it and it's not gonna put your health at risk. Every surgery put your health at risk, but you know what I mean. Go for it, okay? If you want your lips plump to the gods, girl, get your lips plump to the gods. If you want some boobies, here, I got some for you. I'll give you some. Like, people might be like, oh, you're just saying it because your butt. No, girl. Let me tell you something. Big boobs hurt your back. So does a big ass, okay? Welcome to the party. It hurts your back. I have back problems like no other, and I don't have a BBL, okay? Nor a boob job. I want a breast reduction, okay? But listen, maybe a little lipo, but I can't get rid of what is genetic. I can't get rid of my hips. I've tried. Trust me, I've tried. I've tried. Trust me when I tell you this. So yeah, we're gonna leave that in 2023. No more of this. And then as far as the next thing I feel like we should definitely drop and get rid of is toxic positivity. I know you guys love the encouraging words, but listen, I'm a Virgo. Hello, how are you? Welcome to the class. I know this all too well, and I'm sick of my friends doing it. I'm sick of people who I know trying to... No, sweetie, if you want to give me constructive criticism, lay it out. Like, I know some people need a softer approach because they're a little bit more fragile. I'm not the friend to do that, girl. If you're screwing up, I'm gonna tell you and I'm gonna be like, I love you, but this is not this, you know, this ain't gonna work. And you know, it's from love, but I'm not gonna be the friend to just be like, I'm not a yes man, okay? I'm not the friend you want to invite when you're feeling down and you want to hear some butterflies and sugar puff kind of stories. No, girl, I'm gonna give it to you straight because I'm that real one. I'm the real friend, and I'm a Virgo. I really don't have time to be catching up and going back. And no, even with myself, I know when I'm being stupid, girl. I know, trust me, I know. Sometimes I want to be a little stupid. I'll circle back around. Trust me. I know. But I come out of it real quick when I'm done. Okay. We all have our moments of wanting a little, but listen, we come back. Some of us want to stay a little too long. And the toxic positivity is draining. Stop being a yes man all the damn time. Okay. I get you're trying to help your friend. I get you want to be that girl. We all want that girl. But every now and then, that girl gotta come through. And being overly positive can lead us down the wrong track. Life is not cotton candy and roses. You need someone in your corner to shake you a little bit, to remind you, girl, you gonna fall, okay? You need some milk, and that's okay. Let me be her for you, all right? Because I mess up too. But I'm pretty quick to say, girl, get the hell up. Get it together. Okay? Just saying. So that is the second thing we're going to be leaving in 2023. The toxic positivity is it's a done deal. She's signed, sealed, and delivered. No more. She's at the door. Girl, I don't even know her name. Okay? That's done. Okay? This is me editing. Basically, I'm talking about people pleasing. The third thing. Now, this kind of piggybacks off of the first, as far as, you know, self-image. This is the comparison culture. Ooh. So, like, you need to focus on your individual journey without constantly measuring ourselves against others. Each path is unique, and that's the beauty of it. So that's basically it. You stop getting on Instagram and comparing yourself to these other people. One, we never know the real tea, okay? You never know what these people really got going on behind closed doors. They're saying they're millionaires, girl. 5 months from now, they scammers. you know? So don't compare too much. I know it's so easy to get caught up and be like, oh my God, she has this, he has that. I wish I could drive this. Girl, let me tell you something. Do you know what a lease is? Do you know what a cosigner is? A lot of these people don't own half the stuff you see. And even if they do, how do they get it? We don't really know. And even if we do know, that's their path, right? That's their situation, not yours. And you shouldn't compare. Because when your things come to flourishing, flourish, you know the word. You know the word. When your things come to be at your doorstep, people are going to judge you just like y'all judge everybody else. So, like, just look and like if you're going to like or not. Because I'm very much so a swiper. I just, like, girl, oh, that's cute. Oh, look at the puppy. Oh, my gosh, she has a new car. Oh, look at the puppy. Oh, my, yeah. I have a lot of animals in my timeline because I don't have time for y'all. The comparison culture is going to lead us down a very bad path if we keep it up, because we're not all, there can't be too many chiefs and not enough Indians, okay? We can't all be business owners. We can all work for ourselves. We can all be billionaires, okay? Billionaires. We can all be millionaires. Millionaires. And I feel like that's fine. The way the system is set up, sweetie, it is literally a cat and mouse game. And if you want to sit there and get yourself caught up in a bunch of things that don't benefit you, you're going to be on forever hamster wheel chasing whatever fairy tale that is. You're trying to impress people who really don't even care about you because they're just comparing you to the next person. That's another thing too. Like I said, we are going to move into 2024. In a more graceful and more mindful and selfish era, okay? This is supposed to be the year of just you. Going take self-care breaks, going swimming, going drink some tea and just sipping and breathing in that beautiful air, having a peace of mind, journaling. We are moving into the year where you need to prioritize yourself and what you wanna do above anybody else, okay? That kind of feeds back into what I was saying about the whole toxic positivity. No more sparing feelings, right? Because that shit takes time, okay? You sparing feelings? Oh my God. Oh my God, girl, what are you doing? You're sparing feelings? Knowing that you don't give a damn? You're setting yourself up. Lucille girl, you're setting yourself up. Because that person's gonna call you in the next 5 minutes with some other BS that you don't even care about. And you're gonna be sitting there on the phone like, yeah, girl. Girl, you don't give a damn. You don't give a damn. Like, be a real friend. You know what I mean? You call me about the same issue every 5 minutes. I'm sick of it. I'm done. I'm tired. I'm falling asleep. Do not disturb. But, I mean, it's going to take a little bit longer for you guys to get there. But trust me when I say, once you prioritize yourself, it's a done deal. So the next one is overcommitting. So this was really big for me, especially in the beginning of 2023. I was doing everything. I only have one child, okay? And I chose to be a single mother. People have their weird stigmas. You don't know my story, but I love how y'all assume you do. My daughter's father is very much still in our lives. I just chose to be single. Oh, and we do that thing called talking. We talk. We communicate. So those issues don't bother me, nor him, nor my daughter. But the overcommitting was huge for me because I was thrown in such a whirlwind. I had, like, imposter syndrome. Like I said, the reason I mentioned I only have one kid is because I put on soccer mom hat. Okay, I put on full-blown soccer mom hat. I was everywhere doing everything, working, running my business, which I will get more into a little bit later about the business part. Taking my daughter to all of these events day after day, every day, basically. And I felt like if I wouldn't do that, especially the events thing, I was a bad mom. me, a bad mother. Oh my God, couldn't dare. No, girl, have them kids. I'm just no, but seriously, I had to get out of that. I had to shake myself. Stop overcommitting. It's gonna. Oh, the burnout is so serious. Stop overcommitting, okay? Let's leave overcommitting in the past. Prioritizing mental health means saying no when necessary. And that's what I did. So now my daughter has her events, just not as frequent as before because it was driving me loony. And I work, but I take, as you guys notice if you watch my vlogs, I've been taking a little bit more time off, going a little bit more on trips. That is a privilege, especially with working for yourself, but I have been doing that and I have been benefiting. Okay, like my brain is not knock. I'm not going crazy. So I think for the new year, I'm definitely not gonna bring that in. If you call me and you need me to show up for you, if you haven't showed up for me in like 4 months, do not bet on me. Okay, because I'm gonna tell you no. If I haven't seen you or haven't heard from you in about 4 months, do not call me for any random engagement because I'm not showing up for you. Sorry. I'm not doing it. And that's my boundary. I'm setting these boundaries. I'm not overcommitting anymore. Don't call me for a random business meeting or a random Zoom call. No. That's out the window now because your girl has put up that front. I'm not going to work myself to death, especially when you don't have one life to live that we know of. So another thing too, maybe this is big with women, but I feel like men do it too, just in a different way. We are going to leave seeking external validation in the past. All the other points kind of grouped together. No more of giving a fuck. Okay? I'll say that one more time. We're going to seek self-validation from ourselves. Okay? It comes from within and not from others. So no more prioritizing other people's needs or what they feel we should do. If we don't feel like it's for us, then let's just deny it. Say thank you. Opinion, opportunity. This just isn't gonna fit for me. And I'm not trying to fit in your circle hole when I'm a square peg. I'm not trying to jump through hoops when I like Twinkies. Okay? Like, no. I'm not gonna stress myself out trying to please someone who I really don't care to please. So the seeking external validation also plays a huge part in the overcommitment because a lot of times people do that to get on someone's good side when you don't need to. If they know you're a good shot or if they know you are who, you know, such a great person, maybe they know. Don't let them play in your face like that. They know. So we're not going to do that. The next thing we're leaving in 2023 is going to be neglecting boundaries. What I said earlier, if they can't respect you or call you, or like mine early was, if you haven't hit me up in 4 months, do not expect me to be anything of business relation to you. Do not expect me to pop up on a Zoom call and help you. Do not expect me to back you up in any kind of way. My boundaries. We are now setting clear boundaries. No more toxic positivity. Girl, if you call me one more time and you do not deserve. Clear. Okay, don't call me anymore about the foolishness. If it's not, you know, helping you or you just need a warm shoulder to lean on or something like that, you know, set clear boundaries to let people know that you don't have to be mean about it. But, you know, girl, I joke a lot. I joke a lot. But you want to set boundaries that are clear and people can't over or misunderstand them because some people tend to, you could tell them straight up, just don't call me past 10. What do you mean I can't call you past 10? What? Girl, are you okay? Just don't call me past 10. And if they still try to block them. Do what Steve Harvey said. Set it up so what they call on the phone just explode. The battery fall out. Child, listen. We're leaving this nonsense in 2023. Like, if I tell you something or if I set clear boundaries and you cross them, please know that you are on Do Not Disturb. Or I blocked you. And I'll tell you. I mean, I don't have a problem telling you. But you know what I'm saying. You need to make these clear boundaries. Because people will play with you. There's a line there and people will jump. They will girl, they will hopscotch over that shit. Okay? You need to set clear boundaries for 2024. And we are going to get into scopes with that. We have to. No more BSing. We have to. 7, we are going to get rid of the fear of failure. So a lot of people are like, oh, you start a business. You know, when people fail at businesses, they don't restart them. Girl, that's normal. If you fail, it's okay. That is literally normal. People, especially when you don't come from that background, when you have people supporting you and people backing you with money, care, criticism, you know, anything like that, it's going to be hard. So a lot of people do fail, but don't let that stop you. That's me personally. I'm speaking about business, but it can be honestly anything. If you want to go with the next, go in class, if you want to proceed with another study, if you want to pursue anything, go with it. Don't let anyone discourage you not to do that, because it is hard. But don't let that stop you. This year is the year of getting results and moving at your own pace. So no matter what people say, what they have in their headspace for you, girl, go shooting for gold, okay? So number 8 is perfectionism. This is my problem. Now, I'm not sure about y'all, but if I got any workouts in the crowd, I struggle with this quite a lot. I don't like to put anything out until I feel like it is perfect. And I know I learned that is not true from my first business. That's my second. So for my second business, the first one I kind of had help with, it was family related, but my second business was my online boutique. I did not want to release this until I felt like the photos were perfect, till the models were perfect, till my social medias were perfect. And I learned you can kind of wing it. You can kind of go and test the waters and then and go from there. But like I said, this is just me giving an example. It can be anything for you. Okay, if you want to do ballet and you feel like, oh my gosh, I'm not looking the part, go in, test the waters, see how you like it. Okay, anything, gym, school, therapy. Okay, you do not have to feel things perfect to try them out. And it's such a weird society we live in, because it makes you feel like you can't have any troubles or any problems. It's really weird to even explain that. Because I have met people like that. Like, I can't go to therapy until I fix this. Well, what's the whole point of you going to therapy, girl? People that have seemingly perfect lives go to therapy and they're broken. So you can't be perfect all the way around. And that's kind of the issue here. We need to break that down and open up ourselves a little bit to realize nothing is perfect. It's all seemingly perfect. It's all perception. It's never actually perfect. And I think that's okay. So let's get rid of that imaginary perfection and let's move into 2024 perfectly imperfect. 9 and 10, or I'm going to just sum them up. So 9 is basically the all or nothing mindset. It's okay to celebrate the big wins and the small wins. And I realized that a lot. I was always shooting for like high as goals, you know, $10,000, $30,000, $50,000 months and stuff like that. Just be happy for the little accomplishments. The fact that you got to where you got and you're striving and you're going for the gold is honestly the best thing you can ever ask for. Let's just be real with ourselves. It doesn't have to be all or nothing. The small things that get you there and that you notice that keep going are the big goals, because they lead up to the big goals. So don't shoot yourself in the foot before you get across that border, you know? So we're gonna drop that in 2023. The all or nothing mindset has to go. It's not gonna benefit us in any way. And the sooner we realize we can appreciate the small things to get us to the bigger things, do you really even appreciate the bigger thing? And we're gonna end this video with the best, okay? The best thing we need to bring: neglecting mental health days. No more of that, okay? We're gonna leave that in 2023. We are now going to prioritize our mental health, okay? No more neglecting mental health. Recognize the importance of rest, relaxation, and self-care and meditating. This is so big, because when I go into therapy or when I go into self-care, people tend to think it's only one section of things. Maybe it's the hippie in me, okay? Maybe it's the hippie in me, but listen, self-care to me is me going outside, walking barefoot and sitting down for about 10 to 15 minutes with my daughter. I like to connect with earth. I like to feel grounded. And I'm sorry, but earth is the biggest conductor. Go outside for a little bit, breathe in that clean air, that crisp air. Or hell, you don't even gotta go outside. Open your window and just get a cup of tea. Breathe in the air for a little bit in the morning before you get your day started, and you'll be so thankful you did. Things like that get you going. It boosts you, it makes my endorphins so happy. Going swimming. Oh my gosh. When I go to the gym and I go to the pool, I used to ignore it because I used to swim in high school. But swimming, when I tell you that is self-care for me. Collecting rocks when I was younger. Yep. Mm-hmm. I'm one of those. Mm-hmm. Girl, I thought I was part of the wild thornberries, baby, when I was little bit. I was feeling like droids of the jungle. That was me. But that honestly is self-care for some people. Foraging, collecting leaves, bird watching. Self-care is unlimited to the person you are and the things you're interested in. And don't neglect that. And if somebody thinks you're weird, girl, that's their problem. Because we don't care, okay? We don't care. If someone thinks you're weird, that's their problem, okay? If it's making you feel good, as long as you're not hurting anybody or being a peep in time or nothing like that, okay? I said wild thornberries. I didn't say peep in time, okay? Whatever makes you feel good or helps you benefit your well-being, we are bringing that into 2024, okay? I want to see more people out here watching birds. I want to see more people out here journaling. I want to see that stuff, okay? I want to see more people out here just sipping tea, looking out the window. Not at me, child. Not at me. But at the trees and the sky, okay? Don't be one of them, okay? So, you guys, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up the video today. This is your first time seeing me. I will have more chit-chats. You know, your girl's funny, but I want to be... This is also a very serious video, too. Especially coming from someone who has, like, so many realizations. I watch a ton of content creators, and I'm just like, yeah, I have something to say, too. And I want to add to the conversation, especially it being the end of the year. You're going to get this probably after Christmas. And my vlogs are going to continue as usual, but I will definitely be entering some of these chit-chat videos because I have something to say. And girl, not me. I have something to say like Jasmine Masters. My name is Jasmine Masters and I have something to say. Girl! No, but seriously, you guys, if this is the first time you see my video, make sure you give your girl a like, comment, subscribe. And I hope to see you guys in my other videos coming soon. Everybody, have a wonderful new year. And I hope you drop a few of these things in 2023. All right, see you guys next time.